Coach, a little bit of an up and down weekend. You guys had a lead in the third period against Clarkson. They were able to come back and take that one, but then you go over to St. Lawrence and you get a shutout victory. What can you kind of say about this team's road trip over the regular season?
I think there were a lot of positives to pull from the weekend. Certainly, we're all disappointed about the outcome of the Clarkson game, but I actually thought we played much better in that game than we did against St. Lawrence. Clarkson's certainly a top program right now in the country, and for the large parts of that contest, I thought we were the better team. So we pulled a lot of really good learning experiences from that game. Again, didn't like how the last 10 minutes went. We got a little bit rattled on their second goal and then made a pretty big mistake with under 5 minutes to go that gave them a two-on-one opportunity. So, again, we've got to be better in those situations. That being said, I thought the next night, was a very, very heavy, hard-fought game. Clarkson did a good job of putting a lot of pressure on us, and we just found a way in the third period to grind out a win. So I was happy for our team to come away with something on the weekend, and we were able to utilize a lot of video to teach from this week. So it was good. I really liked the way we handled the physical play. I was telling Ted that when we played Clarkson last year here, I thought they were able to take advantage of our lack of physicality, our lack of strength. I think we have to give credit to our athletic performance coaches for getting our guys really prepared in the off season to be able to play a fast, physical style. And I thought we handled Clarkson's physicality and St. Lawrence for that matter as well. I thought we handled both teams very, very well, and I thought we were aggressive to the point where I'm sure they felt like we were a pretty heavy team as well.
Don't have a whole lot of time to kind of rest on that. You jump right into conference play on Friday night. What do you know about Maine and what are going to be some of the keys to being able to pick up 2 points in the conference?
Yeah, Maine's had an interesting start. They had a pretty dreadful first weekend. I think they lost 7-0 to Providence and 5-0 to New Brunswick. Felt pretty bad about themselves after that weekend, but then they hosted Alaska Anchorage at home, swept them, went on the road and beat Quinnipiac and, split with Quinnipiac. So they're a good team. They lost a couple key players last year to the NHL early, but players like Fossier and Trollmarks are really good players in Hockey East. I think they'll be some of the better forwards. So, again, heavy physical team. That's why I was glad we played Clarkson St. Lawrence, because we're going to see a little bit of that or a lot of that against Maine on Friday. And, assuming that Swayman's in net, I think both he and Steph are probably the top two goaltenders returning to Hockey East, so it should be a pretty good goaltender battle as well.
What is the importance of just getting off to a hot start, a good start in conference play, especially given how much of a hole you guys were in last year?
Well, yeah. I mean, message to our team really is that every game on our schedule is important, and not one more than the other. I don't think we can look at, the next string of games. We have to look at that first period against Maine and be as prepared as we possibly can. We've had a great week of practice. We've improved from Clarkson St. Lawrence, both, physically, mentally. I think that was a big thing to get through the St. Lawrence game mentally. We had felt like we had Clarkson right where we wanted them, and next thing we're down 3-2 and licking our wounds a little bit. The next night, there was a lot of pressure on us in the third, and we withstood that pressure and held on to get the empty netter. So I think those things are good learning experiences, especially for a team that lost a lot of those one-goal games last year. So to answer your question, every game's huge. 2 points in Hockey East at stake. Our team has to be the better team on Friday night. And I feel like if we, stick to our identity, stick to the things that we know we're good at, we'll be in good shape.
How do you feel as though some of the younger and new players have been adopting the identity you're talking about?
I think they've been excellent. There were certainly some nerves on some of the guys. William LeMay is an outstanding skill player. I think he was very nervous. I talked to him today. He said he was very nervous, fought the puck a little bit. But that's, for first-year players, it's either, one game to get those nerves out, two games. Sometimes it's 3 weeks. You just don't know. But I saw a lot of good things that he was trying to do. Jacques Boucault has been outstanding for us right from the start, from the Guelph game on. He's adapted right away. And Andrew Lucas, I would say, you know, if we're kind of pulling out some of the first-year names, Andrew Lucas on the blue line was a difference maker for us as a freshman, first year, sorry, I can't say freshman, first year player. You know, he set up an unbelievable goal against Clarkson, assisted on another, and was just really solid for not being a very big defenseman. He plays big. He's got a lot of heart, a lot of compete, and can make plays for us, so he's really helped us. Yeah, so it was great to have our captain back in the lineup. It was great to have, you know, healthy Max Kaufman. It was, you know, to get three of the guys back. And then today, we found out some great news that Tom Beretta is eligible now. He's had a long wait since the spring to be cleared to play right away after transferring here. So he's eligible to play this weekend. It was a big boost to our team today. I feel so happy for him, because of how nervous he was about what, you know, his future, what the outcome was going to be, and it was just nice to get that final word today. So we're still without Matt O'Donnell is day to day with a lower body injury, and Nick Hamry still not cleared. So those are really the only two that are out. Everybody's back, and feel really good about our lineup right now. Well, the thing that was really impressive is he took a couple big hits. One was a dirty play. I don't mind calling it that. It was uncalled for. And the other was just, you know, there was just a lot of contact in the game. We need to learn from that. You know, we have to be better about boxing out and protecting our cage. And we didn't do a very good job against Clarkson. But, you know, to be banged up a little bit and rattled and then come back and, you know, have a shutout and play unbelievable, is that Steph. He's a great competitor, and you know, I was very happy for him for that outcome. It's certainly nice to get some accolades.
35 saves for him in that game, it kind of seems routine at this point for him. How do you continue to push him to stay sharp and also get better?
Well, if you look at the Clarkson game, it was hands down the best game I've seen Steph Lekas handle pucks. Like he was an extra defenseman out there at times for us, which I think he would say the same thing, that's the one area that if you're looking at for him to be at the next level, you know, after college, those goaltenders have to be able to play the puck and play it well. And he looked like he was a pro on Friday night. Saturday night, it was just a different rink, you know, playing at SUNY Canton, which was fine. It was just the boards were very, very lively, so he didn't have as many opportunities to handle pucks, but he's definitely improved in that area. Jeff Hill, our goalie coach, assistant coach, has done a great job with him. And again, just speaks volumes to Steph's desire to get better, that he picks apart every aspect of his game and tries to get better. So nice to have him for sure. All right, thank you.
I thought we did a lot of good things this weekend. Obviously, Friday night I loved our start, our first half of the game. I thought we were the better team, and that game ended up being a couple bounces and a breakdown on the game-winning goal. But all in all, I think we're pretty proud of our effort Friday night. But for the whole weekend, I think the biggest thing to take away would be to play a full 60 minutes. I think in both games we were very good at times, but we didn't really string it together for a full 60. The second half of that St. Lawrence game, they kind of started taking it to us, especially from the shot count. I think the first period was like 20-4 for us. We were playing our game and then kind of got on our heels, and then sunk down to the way they wanted to play. So I think going into this weekend, the biggest thing to take away would be to play a full 60.
How important is it for this team's confidence to go multiple weekends, string multiple weekends in a row, gathering points, and not go over?
Yeah, that's huge, especially with the hockey starting up Friday. You want every point you can get, especially against a team like Maine, where we got to go to them for two, I believe. So in our rink, we want to take care of business Friday night. We're not going to look past Friday. So that's our biggest focus right now is the first period Friday night.
Has it been encouraging for you guys, considering you played really well for the most part in that game on Friday, even though you didn't get the result you wanted, and then on Saturday, you're playing a team that maybe you feel like you should be. You didn't play your best, but you are able to come out with a win in that.
Yeah, I think good teams find a way to win no matter what the circumstances are. We're encouraged about Friday night, but I think we're still a little bit disappointed that we didn't get a better result. Like I said, I really thought we were going good there. The first half of the game, we were playing the way we wanted to play and having them adjust. And then, it was a physical game. They're a really good team, give them credit. And they kind of started to get to our goaltender. And, the second goal was kind of a weird play with our goalie, a little incidental contact with our defenseman going into Steph. So, we got to find a way to get points in those games. But we can definitely build on the way we battled on Saturday.
Second goal and didn't get the call for taking stuff out of the play. My understanding from coach earlier was that team perhaps got too focused on that and didn't really respond to the next task, and that's what you need to do every single time.
Yeah, for sure. I think we got to refocus, and then that point's a tie game. I thought we had a pretty good shift or two after that goal, actually. I thought we were going pretty good, and then kind of back on our heels, and the game winner ended up just being a neutral zone breakdown, which we got to sort that out, because that ends up being the game. It's a hard-fought game against a really good opponent, and like I said, I think we probably deserved a better result, but at the end of the day, we got to dig down, and when things don't go our way, kind of get it back on track quicker than we did.
Not too long ago, we were talking about some of your preseason goals and starting strong, especially in the conference. How do you feel as though the team has progressed so far in this short portion of the season?
I think we're good offensively. I think we created a lot. Our shot count was pretty high, and we're getting great A's. It's just about burying them now, and I don't think we're too disappointed about the amount of goals we scored this weekend. I think we could have, especially Saturday, we could have put up five or six the way we were going in the first half of the game. So I think if we keep playing the way we want to play offensively and the way we did this weekend, I think we're going to get the results, and we just got to stick to it. Yeah, I think we kind of measure it by grade A's, right? If you're getting grade A's, they're going to start going in. And I think, to answer your question, the biggest thing would be just being hungrier around that pain and putting it through the back of the net. But if we're getting grade A's, grade A chances, they're going to end up going in. So we just got to stay on it and keep playing the way we're playing. Thank you.
I think it's been a great start so far this weekend, especially the first game going against 10th ranked Clarkson. I think we brought it to them for a good chunk of the game. Same with Saturday too, the start of the game. I think the biggest takeaway though is that, like Matt just said, we got to play a full 60 minutes. Like the second half, both games kind of got away from us. And if we stick to our game that we started it with, we'd be right there with them. So I think that's the biggest takeaway. Yeah, I think now that we have our first weekend under our feet, it's going to be kind of easier to do that, kind of more comfortable. It's always more difficult at the start of the season when it's fresh. Now I think we have the experience of our freshmen who have been great so far. And so I think we're better off prepared for if anything goes wrong during the game, we can still bounce back and react.
Chris, deal with that and protect that guy that's in the crease for you?
Yeah.
That had to be a scary moment at the end of that game when he was hurt.
Yeah, definitely. We know that we need to protect Steph. I think in Saturday we kind of showed that. If anyone got near our crease, we were kind of going at them a bit. I think that's a big key for us because obviously Steph is a very valuable part of our team. Yeah, I think the strength-wise, we're better this year. I think we're a lot stronger to handle teams like Clarkson. And we just got to focus on playing our game, but also adapting to how the team we're playing brings it to us.
How important is it for this team's confidence to string together weekends where you guys do get points?
Yeah, I think especially early, I know when I was here the past 2 years, later in the year we were probably kind of playing catch up because there's games that we should have won at the start of the year and we didn't. And I think we realize, especially now, that these games, especially with Hockey East and Friday, they're super important. And we only play 34 games in the season. Every single game matters. So I think, especially now, starting with stringing together some wins, it's going to help us out later in the year. I don't think the message changes, really. I think it's playoff hockey, kind of, to put it simply. Any Hockey East matchup is, you go as hard as you can, nonstop. We only play 34 games in the season, so every game, especially Hockey East, matters.
Thank you.